Today, we start with chapter 5, natural pressure. We have a lot of structure that we have to know about the natural pressure in order to design. And all the structure we call as a retaining structure. Either it is a retaining wall, or the sheet pile wall. We need to know about the lateral earth pressure and use this pressure to design the retaining structure. And we will design in chapter 6. As in case of the soil, when we have the soil layer, so we can find the effective stress, if the soil at point X, then we find the sigma B dot will equal to gamma dot multiplied with Z. That means effective unit weight multiplied with the depth of the soil. And in case of the horizontal stress, we have sigma H dot. If there is no displacement or no lateral strain, we can find the sigma H will equal to K0 multiplied with sigma B dot. That means sigma H dot equal to K0 multiplied with sigma B dot. So this K0 we call as a coefficient of the earth pressure at rest condition. This for K0. That means no lateral strain or no lateral displacement. This will be the at rest condition. And to find the K0, in case of the granular soil or normally consolidated clay, we can find the value of the K0 from this equation 1 minus psi phi dot, when phi dot is the internal friction angle with the drain condition. But in case of the normally consolidated clay, we also can estimate from the PI value. By this equation, that means we can use both, either it is granular soil or normally consolidated clay, if we know the phi value. But for the clay, if we didn't know about the phi value, then we can estimate by this equation 0.44 plus 0.42 multiplied with PI in percentage divided by 100. And for over consolidated clay, we can find the K0 by this equation. That means use K0 for NC. Then multiply with the OCR power 0.5 or square root of the OCR number. And from elastic analysis, the K0, we can find from the Poisson ratio divided by 1 minus this Poisson ratio. And the distribution of the stress or earth pressure on the wall, it will be as a triangular shape like this. We used to study in soil mechanics. That means at the wall with the height equal to h, then at the end of the wall, Okay, the stress will be K0 multiplied with gamma H. Okay, in this case, if no water, that means the unit weight of the soil equal to gamma. Okay, so then effective stress will equal to total stress. Okay, because of no water. Okay, then we can find the resultant force. Okay, that means P0 will be the area okay, of the stress distribution. Okay, then we will get P0 equal to 0.5 K0 gamma H square. Okay, and the location of this P0 will equal to H divided by 3. But if we have groundwater level, okay, that means with partially submerged soil, okay, like in this case, if we have the groundwater level at about H1 from the ground surface, okay, and below the groundwater level, we have the thickness H2, okay, of the wall. Okay, then we can find the sigma v that okay at any point. Okay, so will equal to gamma h1 plus gamma that z minus h1. Okay, so at any point. Okay, then it's starting with point A. Okay, equal to zero. Okay, at point C mean H1 okay, will be K0 multiplied with gamma H1. Okay, at the end of the wall, okay, we get K0 gamma H1 plus gamma dot H2. Okay, that means for this effective lateral pressure. Okay, so this will equal to K0 multiplied with sigma V dot. Okay, so K0 multiplied with gamma H1 plus gamma dot Z minus H1. Okay, this is at the end of the wall. Okay, and for the water pressure, okay, at this will equal to gamma W H2. Okay, because we have the groundwater level at this point. Okay, then for the total stress, okay, it will be sigma H dot plus U. Okay, effective stress plus pore water pressure. Okay, that means this term. Okay, plus this term with U. Okay, then we get K0 multiplied with gamma H1 plus gamma dot H2 plus gamma W H2 okay, for the total stress. And then to find the resultant force, okay, we just make the summation of the pressure diagram. Okay, that means the sum of the area of the pressure diagram. Okay, you no need to remember the equation. Okay, if you understand that is the summation of the area of the pressure diagram. Okay, so like in this case, okay, we will have three area. Okay, the first area is triangle. Okay, that means 0.5 multiplied with K0 gamma H1 and multiplied with H1. Okay, you will get this term. 0.5 K0 gamma H1 square. Okay, for the second term, okay, this will be the square rectangular area. Okay, this second term. Okay, that means equal to k0 gamma h1 multiplied with h2. Okay, so you get this second term. And for the third term, okay, this is triangle area number 3. Okay, that means k0 gamma h1 plus gamma dot h2 plus gamma w h2 and then minus k0. Okay, that means minus this value, okay, gamma h1 and total multiply with h2. Okay, this is the height of this area. And then you will get the last term 0.5 k0 gamma dot plus gamma w h2 square. Okay, like this. Okay, let's see the example. Okay, analyze the lateral earth pressure along the wall. Okay, so in this case, we find only the stress or pressure distribution only. If we have the wall, okay, with the 9 meter height, okay, 3 meter is above the groundwater level and 6 meter below the groundwater level. Okay, gamma is 17 and gamma saturate is 19 kilonewton per cubic meter. K0 is 0.6. Okay, then it's better to make the table. Okay, so the first column will be set at 0, at 3 meter, and at 9 meter. Okay, sigma h dot will equal to summation of gamma dot set multiplied with k0. Okay, then we get at 0. Okay, equal to 0, and set 3 meter, okay, will be 7 multiplied with 3, okay, is gamma multiplied with 3 meter, and multiplied with 0.6, okay, we get 30.6, okay, and at 9 meter, okay, 17 multiplied with 3, okay, mean the first layer plus 8 multiplied with 6. Okay, this means sigma v dot. Okay, then multiply with k0, 0.6. Okay, we get 59.4. Okay, and the next column is u, mean the pore water pressure. Okay, at set equal to 0, okay, then we get 0. At 3 meter also 0, okay, mean at the groundwater table. Then at 9 meter, okay, we get 6 multiplied with 10, okay, equal to 60. Okay, then sigma h will equal to sigma h dot plus u, okay, 0. 30.6, okay, and then 119.4. Okay, this is the stress distribution. Okay, if we draw the stress diagram, okay, we will have sigma h dot, okay, 0, 30.6, and 59.4. Okay, for u, okay, 0 at 3 meter and 60 at 9 meter. Okay, and for sigma h, okay, we get 0 at set equal to 0. Okay, 30.6 at 3 meter. Okay, and 119.4, okay, at 9 meter. Okay, this in case that, okay, no movement of the wall, that means the soil is at rest condition.